Hi folks, and welcome to this Phantasm tutorial. I'm Sebastian Bleek, and in this episode I'll be taking you through how to easily apply a temperature tint adjustment in Illustrator. Overall, we'll cover applying a temperature adjustment and applying a tint adjustment. If you want to apply a permanent uneditable adjustment, just select your artwork, go into the Object menu, find Filters, Phantasm, and then at the bottom of the list, you're going to see Temperature Tint. I'm going to hit Escape. For this tutorial, I'm going to go into the Effect menu, scroll down to find Phantasm, and again at the bottom of the list, you're going to see Temperature Tint. This way, I'm actually applying this as a live effect, which means I'll be able to edit this in the future. Clicking on Temperature Tint is going to bring up the settings for me. Now let's apply a temperature adjustment. Over here at the top, I'm going to click and drag on this slider towards the left, and that's going to cool the image off for me. Click and drag towards the right, and that's going to warm things up. Over here in this section, you could enter in a specific value, and once you tab over, you see it's going to update right here in your image. Now let's take a look at tint. All right, when you're working with this slider, you're going to be improving the tones for skin and greenery. When you click and drag towards the left, now we have more magenta in our image. Click and drag towards the right, and that's going to make those greens pop. You could also use the temperature slider simultaneously with the tint. So here we have a little bit of a tint adjustment and a temperature adjustment at the same time. Down here we have our basic options. We have fill, stroke, text, embedded image, and more. Just check or uncheck the boxes depending on which ones you want to apply this adjustment to. Once you click OK, notice over here in the appearance panel, we have this Phantasm live effect. Clicking on it is going to allow us to edit that adjustment. I'm going to click on my artboard to deselect. And that's it for this tutorial. Overall, we've covered applying a temperature adjustment and applying a tint adjustment. Make sure you watch the next episode in order to understand how to apply a brightness contrast adjustment in Illustrator. And don't forget, all of our plugins are available for a free trial at astutegraphics.com. Thanks for watching.